how to be successful in the military.
All my life, been grinding all my life. Sacrifice, hustle paid the price. Wanna slice, got the roll of dice. That's why all my life I've been grinding.
What's up, B3 fam? John Bangsal here with another episode where I discuss the military, fitness, or money. Thank you for tuning in. My goal here is to educate people and to help them out. This is another way for me to serve others beyond my physical location and to give back to the community because the military has done so much for me. Anyhow, if you find value in any of my videos, please like and subscribe to my videos. And if you think that any of this content will be helpful for someone else, please go ahead and share. That helps me reach out other people and grow my channel and gives me the positive reinforcement to keep going and give you guys more valuable content. Anyhow, with that said, what I want to talk about in this video is how to be successful in the military. One of my subscribers commented in one of my videos. His name is George Falcon Jr. George says, I've tried looking at videos on my MOS Intel, but I haven't found much. I would also like to see a video on how to be successful during and after my service with the Marines. I know recruiters most likely tell you what you want to hear, but I want to know what's realistic. Okay, first and foremost, disclaimer, anything that I say here is my opinion and none of the Marine Corps or any of the military branches perspective. This is just all from my experience and I hope this helps. I have six topics that I want to tell you as far as how to be a successful Marine or in the military. But before I go over those six things, I want to pose this question for you. What does success mean to you? I ask that question because success is different for every person that you meet. Whatever you define as success is different for someone else. For instance, someone who doesn't go to the gym as often lifts 135 and they think they're successful. But someone who has been going to the gym might not think that is as successful. It really depends. It's relative. It's different for each person. So first, define what success means to you. I've laid out six things that I think that helps you get promoted and get ahead of your peers. But again, define what success means to you. First thing that I want to talk about as far as being how to be successful person in the military is being an active learner. Okay, whatever your MOS desire is, Intel, right? Find a mentor who has done what you want so you can ask them all the questions and they can give you all the answers to the test. Not a physical test, but literally everything that you need to know so you can become proficient at your job, you can become competent at your job, and ultimately be confident in your job. And that leads me to the next topic that I want to talk about. As you're learning as much as you can on your job, you're gaining all this confidence, you're going to think that you're hot stuff, just remember, be humble. And that is topic number two. You want to be humble. After you gain confidence in your MOS, you're going to think you're hot stuff. Remember, stay humble and don't think that you're better than anyone else because you join service to serve other people. And I would recommend that whatever you learn, you try to teach someone else. That way you can retain and master the skills that you've learned, because I find that when you teach someone else something that you've learned, that showcases that you've actually mastered whatever you're trying to teach. I hope that makes sense. Anyhow, topic number three, it's about appearance. It's how you show up every day to work. You know, do you have a clean uniform? Are you well-shaven? Do you have a fresh haircut in the beginning of the week? Do you have fresh boots? I strongly recommend that you have garrison boots and field boots. Garrison boots, garrison means that you're in the office working on administrative stuff. You're not in the field getting your boots dirty in the mud or in the dirt or in the sand, wherever you are. You want to separate your garrison boots to your field boots, okay? And your garrison uniform, as a matter of fact, and your field uniform. You don't want to mix those up. Just so that when someone who has never met you before or seen you, if they see you for the first time in garrison, you want to blow their minds and have that good first impression, because you know that lasts for a very long time. So your appearance matters, okay? Yeah, there's a saying in the Marine Corps is perspective is reality. If someone sees that, you know, you have a shitty uniform, you got some holes in your pockets or in your trousers or in your long sleeve, woodlands or deserts, whatever the case may be. You want to have that good first impression. You don't want them thinking that you are someone that doesn't care about their appearance. Okay. Enough said about that. The next topic, topic number four that I want to talk about as far as how to be successful in the military is don't cut corners. As you get really good at your job, you're going to find ways to find shortcuts to get it done faster. But getting things done faster doesn't necessarily mean it's the right thing to do. You'll know what I'm talking about as you get really good at your job. But whatever the case may be, don't cut corners. Because someone else who has done your job and has mastered it knows whether you're doing the wrong thing or right thing. If you get caught doing the wrong thing, you're just not having integrity. Do the right thing even when no one is looking. All right, so that's, I believe, 1, 2, 3, 4. First thing I talked about was active learner, being humble, having your appearance squared away, don't cut corners. Topic number 5, as far as how to be successful in the military, is be physically fit. From January until June, that is PFT season. PFT stands for physical fitness test. I almost forgot what that stood for. And from July until December, you have the CFT. They call it the CFT season. CFT stands for combat fitness test. I almost forgot what that meant too. But look those up, know what it entails, and be prepared to go knock those out. Okay. Enough said about being physically fit. I think you know that. I think you're smart enough to know that. By joining the military, that is expected. The last thing that I really want to touch upon, and I've been fortunate enough to see it from a company level. I had the bigger perspective of seeing why certain Marines don't succeed and why certain Marines do succeed, is because they are either PME incomplete or PME complete. You want to be PME complete. What does PME even stand for? I keep saying it, but what does it mean? PME stands for professional military education. So if you're enlisted, you're most likely going to go through Lance Corporal Seminar, Corporal's Course, Sergeant's Course, and Career Course if you end up going higher. Okay, you want to make sure you're on top of that, because one of the main excuses that I find other people saying is, hey, I didn't have time to go do this, or my MOS didn't allow me to do this because I was so busy. The tempo for work didn't allow me to go do this. I mean, that is an excuse, okay? Do not have that as an excuse. If you want to get promoted, if you want to make more bucks, and ultimately to have more freedom and options when you have more money, okay? So be PME complete. That is about it, really. Some of the basic things is be on time. There's a saying in the military is that if you're on time, you're late, but if you're early, you're on time. So make sure you're early at all times. Don't be late, because that goes along with appearance and how you show up to work. You don't want to have that negative perspective from other people. You want to keep that good reputation, be physically fit, and knock it out of the park. Anyhow, those are the 6 things that I think that will help you become successful in the military. As far as being successful out of the Marine Corps, because that's what you're planning on joining, or in the military in general, I think that if you build those habits of doing the right things, of showing up on time, being squared away, and having integrity, I think that will carry over into the civilian side. Obviously, I'm still in the Marine Corps, I'm still in service, so I can't really speak as far as being successful, being in the civilian world or outside of the military. But I will tell you that things that I've learned in the military, I will carry over into the civilian side when that comes. I think the military does a good job as far as training you and molding you to a person that is confident and competent in leading other people in wherever you go in the future. Anyhow, that is it. I hope you find value in this video. Again, if you did, please like and subscribe. Look out for more videos. I'll be coming out with more videos on a weekly basis. So until then, be excellent. Stay tuned. Peace. I can't really reach that, but let me go. Bam! All my life, been grinding all my life. Sacrifice, hustle, paid the price. Want a slice, got to roll the dice. That's why.